Hello everyone, I'm Ashish Jain, Product Manager in the Azure Orbital team. With Azure Orbital, our goal is to empower every person and every organization to achieve more, both on and off the planet. Last year, we announced Azure Orbital as a new conversation as a service available in private preview for our customers. Today, we wish to share more updates with you on Azure Orbital. Azure Orbital is a managed service that lets you communicate to your satellites, control your satellites, uplink and downlink data, process data on the cloud, and thereby scale your operations directly on Microsoft Azure. As part of Azure Orbital, we are deploying multiple satellite ground stations in our data centers, enabling a variety of scenarios, including Earth observation, remote sensing, and global communications, cutting across a variety of industry segments. With Azure Orbital, our goal is to enable our customers and partners with a vibrant ecosystem. Today, we are happy to share with you another great partner in our ecosystem, Thales Alenia Space, who bring great data processing, inferencing, and analytics capabilities to our customers with Azure Orbital. For Earth observation and remote sensing, today we will cover few updates and show you a demo of data processing and analytics using Azure Orbital and satellite imagery. A quick recap on our very flexible high-level architecture. Customer can onboard their satellites on Azure Orbital using APIs and Azure Portal experience, but once onboarded, customers can schedule contacts with their satellites using Microsoft and partner ground stations. With Microsoft ground stations, we leverage ground station virtualization by digitizing the radio signal at the ground station and processing the signal in the cloud using high-speed software modems from our partners running as virtual network functions optimized specifically for Azure. The process data is then delivered to the customer's virtual network where it can be further processed and enriched using multiple other Azure services including compute, storage, AI, machine learning, and cognitive services at enormous scale. Orbital can also provide fully digitized wideband raw signal, that is raw IQ, to the customers for processing for unique scenarios. We have been heads down building our own ground stations in our data centers. This is our first ground station at our Quincy data center in the state of Washington, housing two 6.1 meter antennas supporting XS and UHF bands. Over the course of this year, we plan to build many more ground stations and also make partner ground stations available from our partners to enable our customers to ingest data directly in Azure. Our demo will go deeper into the value chain of Earth observation and demonstrate how satellite imagery downlinked using Azure Orbital can be processed on the cloud for analytics in near real time and provide insights that can transform businesses. We will demonstrate this in three quick steps. In step one, we will downlink Earth imagery from a customer satellite called Demos 2. In September last year, we demonstrated how customers can downlink data from the satellite using Azure Orbital. By showing you a live downlink from Aqua, which is a public satellite owned and operated by NASA. Now for the sake of this demo, we have already downlinked few of the images and parked them in Azure Storage Blob from Demos 2. In step two, we will demonstrate how the raw data from the Azure Storage Blob can be processed by Earth Pipeline, a data processing pipeline for satellite imagery that can enrich satellite images and make them analytics ready. We will then store the processed analytics ready assets in Azure Storage Blob, which we process in step three. In step three, we will demonstrate how these analytic ready images can be inferenced by using deeper vision, a capability by our new partner, Thales Alenia Space, which brings capabilities like change detection, entity recognition, and multiple other artificial intelligence and machine learning on Azure at scale. With that, I invite Chris, Vice President of Engineering at Earthcast, to show us a demo of Earth Pipeline running on Azure. Chris, over to you.
Hi everyone. As Ashish mentioned, I'm from Earthcast. We're a data and geoanalytics company specializing in satellite image processing. I'm very pleased to be here today to tell you about the world's first SatOps processing service called the Earth Pipeline, which can connect seamlessly with Azure Orbital. The Earth Pipeline automatically transforms raw downlink data as shown here into ultra high quality analytics ready data in minutes using rigorous physical modeling combined with the latest advancements in computer vision and machine learning. This quality is key to powering reliable, automated, actionable insights without humans in the loop, which ultimately reduces costs, improves accuracy, and enables scalability. This is a new ground solution specifically designed for the needs of new space. As shown in the box in orange, once a satellite imagery is downlinked, the Earth pipeline does the rest by automatically delivering analytics-ready data straight to the customer or application. This service provides satellite owners with vastly improved quality, latency, and cost versus traditional ground segments, and is backed by a guaranteed SLA. The Earth pipeline also reduces the needs for costly operational facilities, software maintenance, and processing, calibration, and QA operations, which can save satellite owners millions both in upfront costs and in yearly operational expenses. As shown here, the Earth pipeline offers rapid commissioning, including sensor characterization and image sharpening, scientific quality radiometric calibration, sub-pixel accuracy geometric processing, automated QA with a guaranteed SLA, and high-quality mosaicing capabilities, as you can see here on the right. As shown in the imagery, it's both radiometrically and geometrically normalized to very high quality. The Earth pipeline was also recently selected in a highly competitive U.S. Department of Defense Space Challenge as one of the 26 technologies out of more than 800 that are expected to revolutionize the space industry. This service was also created by a team of experts who worked on other world-class ground systems, including the WorldView and RapidEye constellations.
Now let's take a look at what the Earth pipeline can do with the Deimos 2 satellite and Azure Orbital. Once the data is delivered to blob storage, the Earth pipeline can then automatically generate analytics-ready data products as seen in the Azure console. Once processing is complete, the products are ready for automated insights. To give you an idea of what the Earth pipeline is doing, let's look at raw imagery of Sacramento shown on the left versus processed imagery shown on the right. The raw imagery on the left is typical high-quality push-broom satellite data before any processing takes place. After processing, you can see here the Deimos 2 imagery has extremely high radiometric and geometric accuracy that's ready to power analytics at a fraction of a traditional ground segment cost. Now let's take a look at recently processed data of Sacramento from 2021, shown on the right, and imagery from 2016, on the left. Both Deimos 2 images are extremely well normalized to subpixel accuracy, which you can see when you zoom in on the imagery and look closely at the features on the landing strip. This quality is key to extracting reliable, automated insights from the data at scale without humans in the loop. Exploring another area, say the Valley High football field, you can see that both the radiometry and geometry are still extremely well normalized, even though the images are 5 years apart. Next, Thales Alenia Space will show us what they can do with analytics-ready data products from Deimos 2.
Thank you, Chris, for a great overview of Earth Pipeline running on Azure and some of its capabilities that our customers can make use of with Azure Orbital. Now let's see how the downlinked images processed into final analytics-ready assets can be inferenced using deeper vision. I wish to now invite Romain from Thales Alenia Space to show you a demo of deeper vision technology.
Hi, so I am Romain Hugues, and I am an engineer in artificial intelligence for Earth observation in Thales Alenia Space. Today, we'll thus present you deeper vision, a change detection software now available on Azure Orbital, thanks to Microsoft. As you may know, the latest generation of Earth observation satellite connect enough images each day to fill more than 100,000 computer screen. Deeper vision performs automated content extraction from images and enriches images data so the user can request images from given content and focus on tasks where human expertise is really critical. The application we will see today is called change detection and site monitoring. Every time a new image arrives on a given area, deeper vision will compare it with the latest previously acquired image and highlight places that change significantly. For instance, on this region of the Middle East, we have two images taken by European Space Agency satellite Sentinel-2, one from 2016 and one from 2018. Again, so we can see that volume of Earth have been removed in parts of the desert and some new buildings appeared. And there are also a new road. Here is what the change detection algorithm highlights. Everything that's changed. So this is the architecture of the change detection pipeline on Microsoft Azure. It was deployed in order to use Microsoft Azure functionalities such as blob containers, Azure functions, and Azure Kubernetes services. Image data arrives in the blob container, and the next five Azure functions are here to collect information about location and date from image metadata. It results on the right in a queue containing the image pair to be compared. For each pair, a change map is computed with deprovision change detection algorithm using the Kubernetes service, and the output is sent in another blob container. Deprovision will soon be available on Microsoft Azure Marketplace.
Now, this is the demo from deprovision. So, images from Sacramento just arrived in the blob container. We can have a look at it. DP input. Here we have the two images, and the Azure function detects the presence of the image files automatically, and it launched the change detection processing automatically. We can move to the cluster monitoring dashboard and see that the processing pipeline has started, and the CPU usage is following the type of processing, first the pre-processing and then the change detection itself in green. So the Kubernetes cluster is able to autoscale in response to new pair of images, and the processing takes a few minutes for a pair of images, and here it's finished. Now let's have a look at the results. So it is available in the blob container here, and we can download it on our PC. So the download is pretty fast. And we can open the images and have a look at them in a QGIS, for instance, or ArcGIS. So this is the image before with two regions of interest, and the image after 2021. And in yellow are highlighted the changes. So in the urban areas, we will have a look here. So before, after, we can see that there were some new buildings, and these new buildings are highlighted in yellow because of the construction. We can have a look at the other areas. Here, before, construction site, after, new neighborhood, and some changes here. All right. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Romain, for a wonderful demo. With Azure Orbital, our customers can leverage deeper vision capabilities to process their data from satellites in near real-time manner using the power and scale of the cloud. We are proud to hear what our customers and partners are saying. Here is what Earthcast has to say. Earthcast is very excited to use the Azure Orbital platform, which transforms a conventional ground station model to a new on-demand data downlinking service that goes straight to the cloud. This service enables near real-time processing of the Deimos 2 satellite with our Earth Pipeline technology, allowing us to rapidly deliver high-value insights direct to the customer. Here is what Thales Alenia Space has said. Working with Azure Orbital, Microsoft, and Thales Alenia Space are innovating what their customers in the space industry can achieve with the power of the cloud today. Customers can combine Azure Orbital ground segment capabilities to ingest data directly in Azure with Thales Alenia Space deeper vision capabilities to process data and generate timely insights powered by artificial intelligence and machine learning at enormous speed and scale, creating unprecedented impact both on and off the planet. Now let's shift gears and move to Azure Orbital Global Communications. Let's quickly recap and give you a sneak peek of Orbital 5G. By interconnecting their existing ground stations or by co-locating ground stations in our data centers, satellite providers can use our global backbone for delivering traffic to multiple locations, to customers' on-premise network, to customers in Azure in same or another region, or back to their network in another region, or leverage our ISP peerings to exit out to internet. In the process, they can combine various Azure services with Azure Orbital. Let's now take a look at how providers can take advantage of this with Orbital 5G. In the demo setup, we integrate satellite connectivity with virtualized mobile packet core from Affirmed, which is now part of Microsoft, using Azure Orbital. In this demo setup, the remote site only has a radio equipment, that is satellite antenna and an E-Node B. And this can very well be a G-Node B as well for a 5G network. Now, Orbital 5G creates a remote private cellular network running completely on the cloud over the satellite network, providing one hub and dedicated connectivity to the cloud and internet while bringing various Azure services to the remote sites. Let's see a quick demo of Orbital 5G in action. The iPhone has the SIM card which is registered with a private instance of Affirmed mobile packet core running in Orbital Virtual Network. We will now remove the iPhone from the airplane mode. You will now notice that the iPhone seamlessly connects to a private cellular network created by Orbital over the satellite network. Since the cellular network is the only network on the device in this demo setup, accessing internet will be breakout from Azure using Orbital. Hence, you would notice that if I check my public IP address, you will see an Azure IP address. Using Orbital 5G, satellite providers are empowered to achieve more by providing private 4G or 5G cellular services over satellite connectivity to their customers. That brings us to the end of my presentation today. Thank you so much for your time, and please do not hesitate to reach out to me at ashish.jain@microsoft.com. Thank you and have a wonderful day.